Hello and welcome to my channel. This is use of Excel in economic research. I am Kanchan Dutta, associate professor of economics, University of North Bengal. Actually, before using Excel, it is very essential to say the most important thing in economic research, and that is data. What are the different types of data that are used in economic research is the most important thing. Like in pure science, they have their lab, there are lot of instruments, chemicals, but in economics we have only one weapon, that is data. We have to apply lot of tools, techniques on this data to get some idea about the research work in economics. Before that, data is nothing but the information related to the values of a variable. Okay. Now, what are the different types of data that are used in economics? That is, first one is primary data. The another is secondary data. The next one is that is time series data. This is cross section data. This is pooled data. Another one is panel data. Then it is from another angle we can also count on the basis of count. This is ratio scale data, interval scale data, the ordinal data, nominal data, and the population or census data, and sample data. Primary data, generally we collect from door-to-door survey, household survey, and it is not published previously. But secondary data is published data, published by some other institutions, government organizations or journals, something like this. Time series data is data, is a value of the variable over the different periods of time. In cross-section data, collection of data at a particular point of time. If we pool these two, it becomes pooled data. That means the pooling of time series and cross section is the pooled data. Panel data is a special type of pooled data, where the same individual or household, same household or industries or states are selected over several periods of time, or the values of the variable that are selected over the different periods of time. Similarly, ratio scale is one kind of data that can assume, that can we can use any kind of algebraic operations in ratio scale. In interval scale data uses some kind of interval, for example 1 to 5, 1 to 7, 1 to 10, to get the expression of the respondent. Generally in Likert scale we use interval scale data. In ordinal data, we cannot get the numerical value, but we can rank our preferences. For example, the gradation A, B, C in exam. Similarly, the economic condition, very low, low, or medium, or good economic condition. So just to get this rank, we use ordinal data. And nominal data cannot be measured numerically. This is qualitative data. For example, religion, gender, male or female, and we generally use binary number 1 or 0 to identify this variable, nominal data. These are also known as dummy variable also. Now, another classification is census or population data. When you consider all the households within the particular study, this is census or population data, and sample is the part or some collection of population. This is sample data. So sample is the part of population data. Now we are showing some example how the time series data looks, how the cross section data looks. In the upper panel, this is time series data example, a hypothetical example. Here in the first column year is written, in the second column value of the variable, here it is taken GDP value of the variable, and the year is taken from 1999 to 2020. Similarly, in the lower panel, the cross-section data hypothetical example is given here. The data are collected on the basis of a single point of time, at a particular point of time. Suppose here 100 households are surveyed, and these are the different information related to these variables: age, gender, caste, religion, family size, education, occupation, income, etc., etc. Similarly, this is the example of panel data. So panel data is a special type of pool data. In pool data, both time series and cross-section data are pooling together, but respondents are different. But in panel data, respondents, if the respondents are individuals, it may be industries, it may be households, it may be states, country, these respondents will be same, and the values of the variables are taken over the different time periods. So this is the combination of time series as well as cross section. This is the panel data example. Now, before we going to use the data, our first task is to how to handle Excel, because Excel is available software to almost all the researchers, and sometimes SPSS, eViews and other kinds of Stata softwares may not be available to the researchers. As a result, as the basic thing for the beginner, it is very useful to learn Excel. Here in this, the how it looks in the horizontal axis, what is written in the column, vertical axis, how it is written. And if we want to convert any variable in terms of log, what we have to write in the first column, we have to write the value of the variable. In the next cell, give the equality sign, write log and cell value. Suppose the value is here, so we have to write is equal to log of A2 and click, we will get the log value of all. Another important thing, before use the Excel, we have to open the analysis tool pack, which is hidden in all the MS Office and Excel, but it is not explicitly given. So we have to extract from the given information. How we can able to extract this information? It is written line by line. After that, I will show in terms of the computer or practically. First, you hit this button, go upper left hand corner of the spreadsheet and hit this button. Then go to Excel option, last line, click. Go to add ins, that is 7th row, first column, click. Go to analysis tool pack, click OK. Then click data option, data analysis will come. Go to data analysis and click, you can see the analysis tool pack. How it looks, I'll show in terms of one practical example. Suppose this is Excel sheet. So go to the upper left hand corner here, click here, and then go to here, Excel options, click Excel option, then come here, add ins, click here, add ins, then analysis tool pack, okay. Then go to data, this is the data analysis will come. In this data analysis, we can able to do lot of things can be done. So many tools, economic tools or techniques that are given, we can able to use all these techniques for our research activities with the help of Excel. So these topics includes ANOVA single factor, ANOVA two factor with replication, ANOVA two factor without replication, correlation, covariance, descriptive statistics, exponential smoothing, F test, two sample for variances, Fourier analysis, histogram, and so many things. I'll show one by one in my next slide. Here we are going to calculate the one way analysis of variance. Suppose we have four different plots of land in Jalpaiguri district, and here the sample data of potato production from four different blocks of Jalpaiguri: Sodor block, Moinaguri block, Dhupguri block, and Rajganj block. And these are the data from different farmers. We have collected sample of different farmers. Now we want to calculate the analysis of variance one way, means there is only one thing. What does the analysis of variance means? We want to investigate, does there exist any mean difference among the different sets of population from the four sample we have collected from four different populations. So on the basis of this sample technique, we want to investigate, does there exist any mean difference or not. Okay, so how can we do this? First, you go to data analysis, go to ANOVA single factor, click OK. Input range is given here. Input range, since the first column is written here, so you have to give the label and then click OK. Look, the result will come here. Summary, that is groups, count, sum, average and variance. Sodor, Moinaguri, Dhupguri, Jalpaiguri. The ANOVA result showing like this. ANOVA actually is nothing but the ratio between groups, variation between groups, variation within groups. If the variation between groups is much more higher than within groups, then the ratio definitely will be much more higher, and hence this value will be significant. If statistic will be significant, it also implies that there exists the mean difference among the different populations. So here the F value is 8.37. on the basis of P value, that is 0.000502, we can able to take the decision, yes, the F value is significant. Here we can take the hypothesis that there exist mean difference among the four different blocks in potato production. This is one way ANOVA, since we are considering that this difference is due to differences in land or location. One factor is playing role for identifying the different the mean difference in mean population mean. That is why it is one way. Now if we consider two way ANOVA, how it looks like, using the example of potato also, this is two way ANOVA, two way analysis of variance. Here we have to consider, does there exist any mean difference from two angles, from two different angles or two different factors. One factor is taken as area, that is location. Due to locational differences, there may be difference, mean difference. Similarly, there may be differences in the variety, seed variety. So four types of seed varieties of potato are here taken. One is red type of potato. Another is very popular, that is Chandramukhi. It is available in Calcutta also. This is Bhutan seed, and this is white potato seed. So four different seeds are taken in the this axis, maybe in the vertical axis, or in row wise we are considering four different area. So one factor is location, another factor is seed variety, and this is the data collected from survey or maybe in the secondary data also. How can we go for, oh, this is also without replication. We don't have we don't use any data twice or something like this. Only once it is used, red, the Chandramukhi, Bhutan, white, only once. That is why without replication. Had it been used as red, Chandramukhi, Bhutan, then it would be with replication. Now how can we able to proceed for calculating two-way ANOVA? I am showing it in my next slide.